Whoa. My hair looks crazy, but I like it. Anyway, listen, I'd rather look broke and have all the money in the bank than look rich and fly and have zero money in the bank. That is why today we're going to be talking all about budgeting. But first, let's make a healthy snack because we are all about leveling up and being the best versions of ourselves, which includes feeding ourselves, right? So let's do this and get started with the budgeting video. Now, I was looking at something on my phone and one thing I haven't eaten in a long time is a parfait. I don't know if you can see that. I posted this on Instagram. Welcome back to the Level Up Diaries. What is up, loves, and welcome back to my channel. For those that are new here, welcome. On this channel, we talk about everything personal growth, wellness, leveling up, losing weight, and all that good stuff. So if that sounds like something interesting to you, then you should consider subscribing. I'm smiling because I actually love numbers, and as much as people hate this is something that you cannot avoid when it comes to leveling up. A lot of us avoid numbers. I used to be that kind of person that avoids numbers. I love numbers, mostly other people's numbers. When it comes to doing my own numbers, at first I used to cringe because I had nothing and I'm like, what am I going to look at? But when you have nothing, that is when you actually have to look at your numbers, because if you do not know where you are at, you don't ever start. You know what I mean? And that applies to each and every aspect of life. Let me just start by putting this out there. I'm not by any means a financial expert. However, there are certain things that I've been putting into action that have helped me get out of a bad financial situation, and I want to share this with you. This is my own budgeting method that has worked for me, and I hope that it will work for you, because I feel like it's the easiest thing you can do. And I know, like, a lot of us want to get off of the ground, to start a business, to be the best version of ourselves, but honestly, finances always hold us back. And for me personally, to be honest, finances held me back so many times. I never started so many things because I always looked at my account, or even got myself stuff because I looked at my account and I'm like, oh my god, I have no money for this. Yet if you do what I'm about to show you on my computer right now, you're going to find ways to meet your financial needs. And let me tell you something, if you can get yourself stuff, if you feel good, then everyone else around you is going to feel good because you vibrate well. And if things are happening your way, then everything just, you know, kind of, emotions are energy in motion. I keep going back to this. So let us go into finances. Let us get out of this debt stress and all that stuff. Before we get started, I just realized on my laptop that it's 4:44, and I don't know why that excited me. It's just some kind of synchronicity I've been going through all day. I found 111, 222, 333. Now it's 444. I'm just like, oh my god, this is exciting. What kind of synchronicity is this? Anyway, that aside, the first thing I'm going to tell you about when it comes to budgeting is figure out where you are at right now and be very honest with yourself. What I mean by figuring out where you are at right now is figure out how much you have right now, because again, this video is for people that are struggling financially and just need to get their lives together, be the best versions of themselves, get healthy, start businesses, whatever it is that you need to do with your money, this video is for you. So figure out where you are at right now, how much money do you have right now, and all that stuff. And when you are done figuring out that, the next thing you're going to do is figure out how much your ideal lifestyle is worth. Now the reason why I do this is because you know how I have my 10k months as my goal. There is a reason as to why 10k months is my goal, because I sat down and calculated how much my ideal life would be right now, minimalistically. So in order for you to analyze your ideal life, what I personally did is write down each and everything I spend on. And the only reason I know each and everything I spend on is because I know all my transactions in the past 6 months. I've been watching my transactions very closely. I live a very frugal lifestyle because I'm saving to get a place of my own. I'm saving for so many things. I'm saving for a trip. I'm saving for my emergency fund, and all these things are things that I actually need in order to live an ideal life. Anyway, let's go on about the ideal life. This could be different for you. We are all different, and what works for me might not work for you. But ideally, what I wrote down is I need monthly rent. So I want to be able every month to have my rent money. And this is not how much I currently pay, but I just kind of estimated a number that every month I want to pay at least 1200 in a decent place. So I'm like, okay, 1200 every month. As you can see in this line, I just wrote down a list of different things: insurance, monthly spending, wellness, emergency fund. Now, I know a lot of people save $1,000 for their emergency fund. Mine has $18,000, and you know the reason why it has $18,000 is because every month I calculated and I'm like, if I have $1,500 every month, that money is going to help me in case an emergency comes up. For example, right now we're all in lockdown, people are not working. To be honest, I wasn't ready for this because I hadn't yet started saving for my emergency fund. As you guys know, I'm restarting my life from scratch, so I've kind of been living from paycheck to paycheck for the past couple of months, but we're going to change that with this method. We are definitely going to change that. So emergency fund, the 1500 includes my rent for a month. If, let me say, if I pay 1200 or 750, which is what I pay right now, I would still have money on the side for food and all those necessities. So I was like, okay, 1500 times 12. So a lot of people say they save $1,000 for that, but me, the reason why I want 18,000 is I want to be able to pay for myself for the next year if anything happens, without me feeling like, oh my god, I'm gonna get broke, which leads me to that $18,000. Now, of course, there is things like moving budget, and the reason why I have a moving budget is because I'm currently living in an Airbnb. I'm going to make a detailed video about why I decided to live in an Airbnb, so if you're interested in watching that, subscribe to my channel. So I have a moving budget because I plan to move in a year from now, and I want to have that money already set aside for when I move. And then sinking funds. What sinking funds are is those things that, for example, you have, like, I have a very big family, and every month when I was still in Uganda, we used to have this thing where you have to contribute for each and everyone's birthday. You, I come from a family of 21 kids. What do you expect? Like, at least every month there is someone's birthday. On top of being 21 kids, I come from a very extended family, so I have cousins. So I added sinking funds just in case, because as much as I don't celebrate with my family anymore, sometimes I feel the need to give my baby brother a present, my sister a present, my mom, my dad, something like that. So I want to have money set aside just in case I need to pay for those things, I'm able to pay for them. At the moment, I'm not paying for those things because, like I said, a girl is struggling, but we're working on that. I just put it on my budget because it's my ideal life. I don't know if that makes sense. And then donations, of course. Now, donations is a personal thing. I want to be donating, well, it's a very personal thing, so I'm not even going to go into that. And then, of course, shopping. I gave myself a budget of $100 every month. I don't shop that much, to be honest. I think the last time I shopped was in 2014. And the reason why I have shopping on my budget right now is because I need to change my wardrobe. You guys, I cannot wear the same clothes I've been wearing since 2014. And leveling up includes the way you look. And the way I look, I don't, not that I hate my clothes. All my clothes are so amazing, because right now I still wear them and people still turn heads. Not to brag. But yeah, I just need change of clothes, man. I've been wearing the same clothes for the past 6 years. This is the thing about my shopping budget. It's not mostly for me, it's mostly for these YouTube videos. I feel like I'm always wearing the same clothes in each and every video, so that is why I need to make some few changes. Also, for some photo shoots, it's mostly for my brand and not because, you know, I want to look cool. And then the next thing is debt. Lucky for me, I'm not in any kind of debt, like massive debt. I'm so grateful that my parents took care of all my school debts. I know that a lot of people in Canada and the United States, maybe even the UK, have like school debts, and I don't have any of that stuff. However, I still do have some debts, because when I was going through a struggling time, I needed to borrow money here and there, and I need to pay back all those people. So that's a debt I have, which is not even that much. As you can tell, it's 1,200. And I'm grateful that that is the only debt I have. And then, of course, I'm budgeting for a trip. I don't know where I'm going to go, but I was like, okay, $3,000 for a trip. I don't know if I'm going for a trip given the circumstances that we are in right now. And I could have put that in sinking funds, which is what a lot of people do when I was doing my research. But I don't want to add that to my sinking funds. I want that to be an expense of its own. And I want to, you know, save for it on the side. And then, of course, you're going to find investments. This is something we'll talk about in the future if you guys are interested, but yes, investments, and then miscellaneous, just in case anything happens. So what I did was multiply each and every one of those things by 12 to know how much my life could cost me in a year. And after calculating how much my life would cost me in a year, I divided that by 12, and now I know how much I need to make every month in order for me to live my ideal life. Am I making this money right now? No. But I know now when I'm working towards something, I'm working towards this as a goal. I'm working towards making $5,000 every month, because when I make $5,000 every month, I'll be comfortable. After figuring out how much my ideal lifestyle costs, now, remember how I told you guys you need to figure out where you are in life? This is where the cool stuff comes. So I come here and make a budget. You guys, you do not know the importance of making a budget. You know, a lot of us, what we do, when your check comes, you just pay the bills. You don't plan it ahead of time. And this is a problem when you don't plan. Bills are going to come and they're going to shock you from east, west, south, north, and center, everywhere. Bills are going to come. You're going to feel like every check you have, you're just paying bills. And that is very frustrating. You end up spending money on things you're not supposed to spend on, you know, and I'm guilty of that. You know that the other day I was actually going through my statement, because actually, as a question, I'm going to, please let me know in the comment section down below, how many of you guys go through your bank statements every month? Please tell me, please say me, because I'd like to know. When I went through my bank statement, I realized how irrelevantly my money goes. For example, I opened up my bank account and there are some charges that when I opened it up, I was very sure I wasn't going to be incurring those charges. However, 2 years have passed. I wasn't actively using my bank account so much, so these charges never used to come on my card. However, now I'm using my card so much, I have all these charges. I'm looking, you know, last month I had like over $100 on bank charges. If I did not go through my statement, I would never have known that I have like $100 that I could have spent on something else. I've been intending to get a ring light or like any kind of light to help me record videos, because sometimes I want to record videos at night, and that money could have gone there, but it went on bank charges. Yo, yesterday I was on the phone calling the bank, telling them why I have these charges. Now I know, but if I hadn't done that, I wouldn't have known. Anyway, talking too much again, but this is all valuable information. I hope it's valuable for you guys. Please let me know in the comment section down below if it's valuable for you guys, or just give this video a thumbs up. I will know that you enjoyed it. Anyway, or found it helpful. So the next thing we're going to do is, I created this Excel sheet, and just so you know, everyone that is really interested in downloading this Excel sheet can download it. What you have to do is make a copy of it, and when you make a copy, you can alter the copy. The thing is that if I leave this for you guys to edit, everyone is going to be using the same thing and we're going to be having problems back and forth. Or if you need any help with it, just let me know, or DM me on Instagram. By the way, if you're not following me on Instagram, what are you waiting for, guys? My Instagram handle, I'm going to leave it above. Now that you know how much your ideal life costs, you have an idea of where you are at in life. You know how much you make right now versus how much you would like to make in order for you to live a comfortable life. The good thing about this is that now everything is up to you. And this is something I kept on telling you guys. Just stop focusing on the things you have no control over and focus on the things you have control over. Now, this is what you have control over. For example, let's say if you get paid twice a month or once a month, it depends. Use this template the way you want. I'm going to use this template, and let us say, for example, I'm going to give my own example. This month, I'm expecting 4 checks, and those 4 checks come from 3 different places. The first place is my job that I have right now, and I already got 1 check, which is about $2,220. And then I expect a second check, let's assume it's about $1,000. And then I do freelance work. I help people with social media marketing, and I also do websites. Oh my god, you guys, I never thought I'd be doing people's websites, but I do. Anyway, so I have a contract, and that contract is about $750 every month. And then Madame Bay, my business, I always have to pay myself, because if I don't pay myself, I'm going to be very frustrated. Let me tell you that. I realized that the hard way. At first, when it came to this thing, by the way, I used to use my business money. I just started paying myself this month, because earlier I was struggling. And when you're struggling, you kind of don't differentiate between your business money and your money. I couldn't pay my bills. I had to use my business money to pay my bills. This month, I'm separating it. So I'm paying myself $500 every month. But this is the thing. The good thing about this, now everything is in my own hands. I know I have to make much more money in my business in order to pay myself more, because I don't want to be employed. And because I don't want to be employed, I'm not looking at finding another job. However, I'm looking at putting in a lot more work in my business. And for you, maybe you could find another job. Maybe, I don't know, it's up to you. Figure out what you need to do in order for you to level up and make more money. But now you know you have to make more money, and now you know how much money you need to make. That is why I told you this video is going to be step by step and so in depth. I just hope it doesn't get too long. After figuring out my total income for the month, we have fixed expenses. Fixed expenses are things like your rent. My rent right now is $750, and then my cell phone bill at the moment is $50, and then I have debt, as you can see over here. I do have a debt of 1,000 something something, and in order for me to finish it in the next 12 months, it tells me this is how much I need to pay. But am I going to pay this, really? No, I'm not going to pay it at this rate, but I just want to know that this is the distribution, you know. Now that I've paid my rent and phone bills, which for me is the most important thing right now, I don't have any electric bills, so thank God, because if you live in an Airbnb, that's the one of the advantages. So we'll talk about that in the Airbnb video. Car bills, I don't drive right now. I live downtown Montreal. There's metros everywhere. I'm so close to work. I'm so close to each and everything I need, shopping malls, whatever. So I don't need a car at the moment, but if you have a car, put that there. When it comes to debt, like I said, I have two debts, and one of them I'm going to be clearing $100 this month, and even the other, I think $100. Actually, I didn't quite explain what I'm doing right now. What I'm doing right now is that I use this rule, which is the 50-30-20 rule. What that simply means is that you spend 50% of your check on fixed expenses, then 30% on flexible expenses, and 20% on saving. However, everyone is different. Just distribute this how you want, because everyone has different needs in life. So after you fix expenses, the next thing you're going to move to is flexible expenses. In fact, you know what, we're going to pretend like I don't have all these forms of income, because you know what, now that I have all these incomes, I'm only catering for people that are making at least $5,000 a month. Let's take all that out and just pretend we're starting from scratch and zero. Let's act like I'm getting $2,220 every month. So as you can see here, I put this part for leftover, meaning that every time you distribute the money in one of these things, you see how much balance you have. But the reason I have this part of the balance you have is because I have to spend each and every dollar that I'm getting, because if you do not distribute that money, you're bound to use it for things that you don't need. Even savings is an expense here, keep that in mind. So I was on flexible expenses, so groceries, I put $200 a month, which is ideally $50 every week. Recreation, this is something I like to do for myself. And then fun with friends, this I give myself a $25 budget every week. If I want to have drinks, if, you know, one of those things, eat out, whatever, I put fun with friends. I give myself $100. And then when it comes to burgers, it's my sister, so this is a one-time thing. It's her birthday this month, so I intend to send her some money. I put a budget for that, like I told you guys, sinking funds. Then Madame Bay, right now my business and my personal life are kind of intertwined, and I wanted to buy a light, like I told you guys. Checked online, it's about $250 for the light I want, so $250. But you have to keep checking on the balance. Now I just checked the leftover, and oh my god, I have only $270 left. I want to do shopping for myself, so I give myself $100. But this shopping, I might not do it. Also, I want to get boxing gloves, as you can see over here. But the boxing gloves cost this much. When I go over here and see what's left over, it's $170. If I pay for the boxing gloves, I will only have $66 left. Now, $66 is the extra money I have left. That's why I'm saying every money, like, account for each and every money so that you know. Now, of course, there's things that I need to save for, like my emergency fund. It's a lot of money, like my debts, all that stuff. But then I also have to figure out the things I need in my life. If I don't eat, I'm not going to be happy. If I don't have my recreational stuff, I'm not going to be happy. If I don't send my sister money, I'm not going to be happy. You know what I mean? Anyway, now I know where I'm at right now with my money. So I'm just going to kind of take this out, because I need to see where, how much I have right now. And also this $250, I think I'm going to find something that's cheaper. You see the reason when you budget and for each and every cent, you know where to distribute the money. So I'm just like, okay, I'm going to reduce on the budget for the light. And then I have $220 left, as you can see here. So for that leftover, what I'm going to do is bring it over to my emergency fund. So I could save for a trip, I could save for a moving budget and all that stuff. But I have a place to stay right now, and I have extra money. Also, this money could actually go to the moving budget if moving comes before the emergency, you know what I mean? But right now, I'm going to put it in my emergency fund. And when you go back over here, you'll see that you have zero. So now I know I've spent all my money. I know I'm going to be able to save $220 this month. I know I'm going to pay some of my debt. I know I'm going to get all my necessities without feeling frustrated. Now I just have to find a way of making more money in order for me to meet my needs. After distributing all this, this might be, yeah, it's all fun and games after you distribute it, but then there comes a time when you have to spend the actual money. When it comes to spending the actual money, it's also a different thing. I also created an Excel sheet for it. You have access to all these things. Now I have this budget thing. I actually found this budget template on Google, which is kind of interesting. I just switched it out to be my own. What I'm going to do here, we are pretending like we are starting from scratch again. So here I decided I'm going to put my balance at zero because we are starting from scratch. I have zero. Like I told you guys earlier, I broke down each and I've been tracking my expenses for a very long time, and because I've been doing that, I know the categories that I normally spend on. So I come here and create different categories. After creating these categories, I kind of give them how much each and every one of them is going to cost. Don't touch anything else. This other stuff is going to compute itself, and the way it does is here. Let's give an example. On 8th June, I got a check from check one, 2,200 something. And then I'm expecting another check here. You put the number, you put the whatever, and then the category. So the category automatically computes here. Now you see here it has 2,200. Under the transaction still, you come here and you'll write, for example, let me give an example, rent. I paid rent. I write rent, sorry, amount rent is 750. I paid for rent. Description, rent. Category, rent. This is the thing, I like to track each and every transaction I make. That means each and every day when I spend any money, bank charges, whatever it is, I put it over here. And at the end of the month, let me just fill in a bunch of things right now, and then I'm going to show you what it looks like at the end of the month. When I come here to the summary, I'm going to look and I'm going to see like, oh, I spent, no, that's not a good example. Let's put about $250 on recreation. When you put $250 on recreation and you pass your budget, it's going to show you here that, you passed your budget. Now, like I said, I live a very frugal lifestyle. I want to see everything not red, and I don't want to see everything like net. Apart from rent and phone bills, which are kind of standard, everything else, whatever budget I put out for it, I always make sure to go less than the budget. That's why it's important to track all your transactions every day. The more you track your transactions, the more you make mindful decisions on where to spend your money. Now that I have my whole budget, now that I've done all these things, I know exactly where I'm going to spend my money. Even if I need to make some changes, I will make changes based off of what my numbers are showing me. And number one, I will be within my budget. Number two, I'm going to be saving. There is this thing that people do a lot. They like to live outside their means. Please, can you live within your means? I don't know why people like living outside their means, to be honest. I don't know who you're trying to impress. I know when you're in school, maybe a lot of high school kids do this, even college kids, even adults actually do this. They just like to impress and have the coolest stuff. But cool stuff for who? Like nice for what? When you think about it at the end of the day, if you're not comfortable and you're just keeping up appearances, that stuff is stressful. It's so stressful, you're going to be depressed in life. So quit that stuff. Focus on you, focus on what makes you happy, and focus on what you can do within your means, okay? Now that I've shown you my Excel sheet, I just need to put some things out there. Every time you get your money, plan for each and every single coin, because if you don't, money has a tendency of coming and passing through your fingers without knowing. Like you're bitching, oh my God, I got some money. I'm going to buy you guys some drinks. Oh, our lunch is on me. I'm going to eat out. I'm going to meet some friends. There's so many things we want to do. And if you don't like have a hold of our budgets, they just kind of get out of hand. And it's really easy for budgets to get out of hand. Let me tell you that. I know. So guys, I know there was a lot of numbers involved in this video, but I hope you found it helpful. I hope it helps you budget and save. And if it does, or if you're going to use this, please let me know in the comment section down below. Now that we have put the budget thing out of the way, the next thing we're going to be doing is leveling up when it comes to health. And when it comes to health, you know where health comes from? You are what you eat. And the biggest excuse I get from my clients is, oh my God, healthy food is so expensive. I'm about to break that myth for you. In the next episode, we are going to go shopping and we are going to do meal prepping and all that good stuff. So if you're interested in watching that video and you don't want to miss any quality content from me, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up because it really supports my channel. As always, do not forget to stay motivated, be patient, trust the process, and spread the love. I will see you in the next one. Bye.